to the last ever Heat's Big Night In with TalkTalkTV. For this year. It's been amazing. This is where we deep dive into all of our favourite shows from over the weekend, like X Factor and Strictly. And we have one incredible lineup. So please give it up for my incredible guest from everybody to love. We start with Strictly.
Morning,
Lauren. So it was the Strictly final on Saturday night, and let's just remind ourselves of who won the Strictly final on Saturday night.
The votes have been counted and independently verified, and I can now reveal the Strictly Come Dancing champions are
What did you think of the winner? Like, what did you all think? Deserving winner, Stacey?
Definitely. Like, yeah. I've seen everybody work so hard throughout the whole of the journey, and Stacey, bless her, she just gave it her all. And on Saturday night, I think everyone saw that. So yeah. Really chuffed for her and Kevin.
And Kevin as well. I was so pleased that Kevin won, because actually, during the show, I don't know if you saw, there was a little bit of tension with him and Craig. He was like, you know, dissing him a little bit, but I was really happy for him at the end. Before we talk about your dancing though, I want to know everything about the rap party. Because, firstly, did you happen to see Giovanni and Ashley snogging?
Do you know what? I'm gonna be a party pooper. I left because I hurt my knee, so I didn't, but...
No.
I do know that I got a text off AD at about 3 a.m. So I know that he rolled in real late.
Okay, so he's the guy.
And he was
lead.
Like, but I will be there for you tomorrow in Birmingham. So I was like, okay. Oh. But I've heard that it was amazing.
Yeah. And any other gossip? Like, what's the deal? What about Diane and Joe? Because they
posted on Instagram.
Yes.
It's like, was that saying like we are together?
I thought
that's
it was.
How I took it.
That's exactly how I took it.
It was like a photo. It looked like they were walking down the steps.
He said he won the real prize.
Yeah, he posted a clip saying, I got the $1 million prize. And it was a very loved up photo. I called it. I said I felt the chemistry. Did you sense anything?
Do you know what? They've been an amazing duo throughout the whole journey. And I really hope they are together because he's great, she's great. And he did his hair red for the final. I mean,
he did. Oh, and so, he looked amazing with the red hair, didn't he?
He said, I may not have won the glitter ball, but I've won something a million times more special.
Oh,
come
on. So many hair dye deals from that. You made the semi-finals, Lauren.
Yeah.
You did it. That was amazing. And I have to say, it's like so courageous to do something like Strictly anyway, because you did it, Pete.
Yeah.
The nerves.
Oh, yeah.
Very. I was saying so to you before, much. Didn't I? It was the most nerve-wracking thing I've ever done, ever. It's just when that sort of music comes on just before they
dancing.
Say,
it's when they say dancing and you're like, you know it's coming.
Did you ever have a moment where you walked out and you're like, I don't know any of my moves. I don't know, do you know what I mean?
There was only one time that I really did forget and messed up. It just happened, the camera angle AJ was in front of me.
So perfect.
It was just,
You just swayed it out behind
after
him.
After that, I never did it again.
And what was AJ like to work with? Because, I mean,
apart from easy on the eye.
Yeah. Unbelievably symmetrically beautiful. He did say that, like, after week three, he felt like you were starting to enjoy the dancing. Is that how he felt?
Definitely. I think once I relaxed into it, never danced or performed or acted in my life. And that was the hardest part, was finding the cameras and the red lights and then acting. He was like, you don't look like you love me, Lauren. And I was like, I'm trying to act, AJ. He's like, you're slapping me, you're not caressing me. Like, but
I say that to my wife sometimes. When she says the slap was an affection, I went, oh, right.
I think as a teacher, AJ, and I don't think people gave him enough credit, because, you know, you can choreograph for someone with two hands and you can do all these weird and amazing things. He had to really think outside the box. Being in a ballroom hold was not natural for him, because obviously he was making up for the limited space. All the lifts, like, we did some lifts that needed two hands.
Yeah.
And, like, if they didn't go right, he was going to drop me. So I would have blamed him.
But he never dropped you.
He didn't.
He never dropped you. Give it up for AJ. Yeah. It's weird though, because will you miss all the, like, the makeup and the glitter, because you're used to sports
exactly clothes, it was all that. Glitter and makeup, and I learned so much, like,
yes,
how much you can actually put on your face and, and contouring and the different
it's a magical world.
But I didn't realize quite what goes into making such a masterpiece. Like,
for me,
I was just sweaty in a nightclub all the time. Like, I didn't really bother. So
yeah, so will you miss that, like?
Well, I think I've learned a bit, so now I can sort of do my own and I won't look so shabby.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No,
I might not wear it when I'm training though, because, yeah.
Yeah, Lauren looks glam on the
red ball. Yeah.
And Pete, you, like we said before, your partner was Jeanette Manrara.
Yeah,
the lovely Jeanette. Right. I think we have a clip of you doing the cha-cha slide.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yes,
can we just have a look at you, Pete, doing the cha-cha slide? You've got some really good hits.
Well, Jeanette, because she's got that Latin blood.
Yeah.
She just, that kind of dance just came alive. And watching her, you've got to up your game when you're standing next to her, because she's so...
You've got to keep up with her.
Yeah,
you know?
Absolutely.
And that's what I feel about you and AJ. You were always in sync. Like, you know, I thought, how is she keeping up with him? Because he's like a ballroom dancer, you know, and he's going...
He whizzes around that room.
Yeah.
I think it just took hours and hours. I don't know, how many hours did you put in? Like, we went from 8 a.m. sometimes till 10 p.m. at night.
Yeah, no,
every
I never went that hard. I was 10 till 4.
Oh, right, yeah, you're hard.
I was like, but did, as soon you didn't as 4 o'clock came, I went, gee, I've got to go and pick up the kids. I'm really sorry. I was exhausted. I am 45. You've got to understand, like, I'm not 20 like you, right? So that, do you like that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not 20 like you, where you kind of feel like you can go, I mean, I can't, not that you can't go on all night, I mean, like, you can't go on. You know what I mean? Rehearsals, you know, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
It stops at 40, no, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
What will you and AJ stay in touch with each other? Because you did say on Saturday night, you're actually not going to stop dancing.
I hope not, and AJ sort of made a comment yesterday that maybe I'll be on his personal tour of a little
really?
Surprise visit.
Yeah, that'd be amazing.
I think the one thing with me and AJ is people don't realise how driven and competitive he is, so we're quite similar in mindset ways and stuff, so definitely hope to stay good friends with him, because we've had such a journey, and I think we didn't realise quite the impact that we'd have on everyone.
Yeah.
So.
And when he was on our show, actually, he was saying friend for life.
Yeah,
you know, because you spend so much time with him, don't
you? Yeah.
And the tour?
Yes, so excited.
So when does the tour start?
Starts on the 5th. We start practicing then for a week, and then we just literally city hop all the way around the country.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And there was actually one question I wanted to ask about Strictly, was the whole Ashley situation. Mm-hmm. You must have heard about it. They were quite hard on Ashley because she was a professional dancer and she was in the she was in the bottom two with you, the dance off, and everyone was outraged. Do you think people are a little bit unfair because, you know, she was a professional dancer, she shouldn't have been in it?
Yeah, well, with Ash, like, when I watched her, I feel mesmerised, and I sort of knew when I was in the dance-off with her, like, I would never be able to dance, you know, to the beautiful level that she does. But I think she was also a good role model. Like, she took me, especially after my Viennese waltz, she was just like, Lauren, that was amazing. She took me under her wing, and she was saying, like, find the cameras, act more, don't be afraid. So. To me, like, I loved what she was able to give me, like, through her experience. So for me, like, I think it was sad that she was in there 3 times, but both her and Faye were just such good role models, and I felt mesmerised when I watched them dance.
Beautiful dancers as well.
Definitely.
Faye and Giovanni, I was like...
Oh, yeah, they
Giovanni,
were.
Giovanni, yeah.
I had such a fangirl moment when I met her at Hyde Britain, and I was like, oh my God, it's Faye from Step. She's like, oh my God, it's Laura from Love.
What is it? It's not all about...